Hi everyone, Tracy Duran here. You might know me as one of the admins on the site Aurora, Illinois, Our City of Brand Lights Past Present, with my wonderful friend Jill Amoni. I've contributed a few stories here and there, you know, usually of my childhood and growing up in Aurora. I've also shared some vintage photos I found here and there, you know, that I find along the way, which I hope, you know, everybody enjoys. I'm also the one who comes up with the goofy questions, like, you know, what's your, you know, favorite smell that comes, you know, that takes you back, your favorite food to eat and everything, things, you know, and which is, you know, stuff that, you know, I enjoy, you know, doing, because I know, you know, thinking about smells and tastes and everything, digs deep to everybody's memories. And for you to think back into, you know, your childhood, your past, or anything like that, you know, it means a lot to me that you guys, you know, do your remarks or implies and everything of, you know, the things that you remember, because I hope that it brings back, you know, wonderful memories for you guys that, you know, that you're thinking back, you know, to those fond memories and everything. Just a little bit of background on me. I was born and raised in Aurora by my parents, Jerry and Lainey Fredrickson, along with my sister Lori. We originally lived in, when I was born, we originally lived in Mokerville, and until about 1979, and then we moved to Gate Street, 509 Gate Street to be exact, back in 79, and my parents stayed there up until, probably around 2000 something. But anyways, you know, loved our house and everything. And so basically we lived off of Gates and Fifth, Fifth and Gates. So, you know, which I know is, it's a very unique way that all of us here in Aurora can say, you know, where we live. You know, we don't have to be exact, but we know exactly what we're talking about or what everybody else is talking about. So my dad worked at Allsteel for, you know, many years up until 1989, and a few, you know, health setbacks and everything, ended up passing away in 1999. My mom, she worked at Copley, and you know, both at the old Copley and new Copley, up until recently. She worked there for well over 40 years and reluctantly retired. So right now she's living the happy retirement life in South Carolina. But, you know, just to give you some background on that as well, that's the reason why I have such affinity for the old Copley building. And I'm fairly disappointed with, you know, what happened to the building. I hold a lot of fond memories, and I basically grew up there. So, you know, especially like on Saturdays, you know, I'd be bored, so I would walk from our house all the way to the old Copley. And basically, you know, my mom worked in registration, so I would just, you know, help her out with little mini stuff and everything, you know, kind of get her work, you know, her work day finished up, you know, help her along and stuff like that. So, you know, fun memories like that. You know, my dad grew up in Aurora as well. You know, he was born in 1941. You know, the Fredrickson family and everything. Not related to the Fredricksons of the office supply store, in case anybody's wondering, because I do get that asked a lot. So I hold dear all my childhood memories of growing up in Aurora. You know, I have a lot of fond memories. Aurora's, you know, my hometown. Heck, Aurora's your hometown, your new hometown. You know, it's our town. So, you know, we make it what it is, you know, especially with our memories and everything. Granted, I know a lot of us are, you know, somewhat disappointed with, you know, how the downtown is, because downtown was the hub of Aurora. I mean, we're the second largest city in Illinois. So you would think that, you know, there was some pride in there, but it's a matter of, just all of us getting together, trying to figure out something to make it great, But you know, there's a lot of history in our town, Aurora. So, anyways, I'm sorry. I have to read because I had to write this down because I tend to go on weird tangents, which I'm sure you've noticed with my my questions on the sites and everything. Let's see. So sorry. So when you guys share memories, on the Aurora sites, it's really wonderful. And and what's neat too is that I get to see people catching up with old friends. They'll see somebody be like, "Hey, are you so and so's brother or sister?" and everything. So it's a lot of fun to see that. But so now you kind of have a idea of who I am. If you want to know more, you can always message me. or you can always friend me, message me, whatever you like to do. I now live in North Aurora with my husband, Joe Duran, also known as Coyote Duran. He's an artist, and he also works for two online sites. One is for Ring TV, which is Ring Magazine, boxing and things like that. And UCN Live, which is another boxing site. And we live here with our daughter, Michaela. She's 8 years old, who is right now in South Carolina visiting her grandparents. And she's having a blast. We're having a blast because we get to sleep. And I'm sure a lot of parents would understand, it's nice to have, and yes, that's her back there. We love her to death. We totally love her to death. But sometimes parents do need a recalibration and everything. But so that's the gist about me. The point about my video here is I want to share with you one of the places that I truly enjoy. I love history. I love research, and I'm sure most of you may know now. Because I put little tidbits here and there. I'm actually in the process of writing a book about Leland Tower. And, I mean, it's not like factual, historical kind of thing. But it's more of a historical fiction, paranormal mystery, crime thing kind of thing. So there's a huge mixture in it. And hopefully, once it's done, it's been many years that I've been working on it. Right now I'm getting all the nuances since that's the questions that I'm throwing out to everybody because I'm trying to make this very unique and trying to make it as accurate as possible too because I know a lot of folks in Aurora like to have things as accurate as possible about their hometown, which I totally understand. I'm the same way. And so one of the facets tools I use is the library, our Aurora Public Library, the Santori Library. I'm sorry, I have a friend named Santori. Santori Library, and I utilize the microfiche over there where you can check out the old newspapers and everything, and a little background on that as well. When I was in high school, freshman or sophomore year, East Aurora High School, my parents went to the movies, took me with, and they wanted to see The Untouchables. But they thought that was going to be too violent, or graphically violent, or too bloody and everything for me. So instead, they went to see in the same theater, I think it was the Fox Valley Theaters back in the day. They went to see The Untouchables. They sent me to the theater next door to them to see Spaceballs, of all things. So when my mom realized that The Untouchables wasn't as bad as what she thought, they took me to see The Untouchables. And I fell in love with that, especially the fact that they filmed a lot of, a lot of scenes in Chicago, especially the Union Station scene, which is another favorite of mine. So being a kid and knowing the stories of the gangsters in Aurora, which I know a lot of people probably roll their eyes. They're like, yeah, whatever. You know, they have those stories of, you know, like their grandpa or their great uncle will say, you know, oh yeah, my friends, cousins, sisters, boyfriends, great uncle's brother was serving steaks to Al Capone up in Sky Club and everything. Well, I have one of those too. You know, we all have our stories. My story is my Uncle Rusty had served steaks to Al Capone. You know, it's, but you know what? Those are our stories. Every family has a story, which is very cool for us Aurorans. You know, we have that connection to Chicago history, you know, gangster history and everything. And so it's, you know, we should embrace it, you know, whether it's factual or not. It's always fun to have. I mean, you know, you have storytellers and everything, and it's just fun to have that sort of story, you know, within your family. So with the Untouchables, I found out from my mom, or my mom or my dad, I can't remember. I'm 45, so I can't remember. But anyways, you know, I found out about the microfiche. And so basically my mom would drop me off at the old library and on a Saturday morning, and I would, you know, request permission to go. It was up on the third floor. I would go in there and, you know, just check out stuff from the 1920s. It was so fascinating seeing these stories that happened in Chicago, you know, like the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. O'Banion was the Irish mob boss who was killed in his own flower shop. And his flower shop basically created all the flower arrangements, I'm sorry, for all the other gangsters' funerals and everything, which now the flower shop is a sandwich shop in Chicago. So, you know, it's like every place has a history. And which another thing I find fascinating, because our old house, you know, was built in the 20s, and you know, it's just fun to go back in history. And so with the whole point of my story again is, you know, to do research, to figure out the history of your own hometown, and finding so many different things you didn't even realize existed. And so that's like what with my research for my book, finding out, you know, that back in the 40s, most of my story relates to around 1941 in the Sky Club. And just finding all the stuff out about the Sky Club and the building itself is fascinating. So like with downtown Aurora, it was the mecca of entertainment. There were so many movie theaters, music halls, dance halls, you know, just everything. And plus, you know, there's so much industry too. And I mean, it's, you know, back then, you know, I mean, obviously, I mean, we're all proud. I know the majority of us are very proud of Aurora. But you know, from back then, you know, with everything in downtown Aurora, it was just a huge hub, you know, including, you know, the train station and everything. And which, by the way, my own family history, I have my great uncles and actually my great grandfather Fredrickson had worked over at the CB&Q station, you know, CB&Q workshops. My grandfather, Louis, he worked at the Sky Club, actually. And actually do have proof to show you. That's one of the other fascinating things with doing research, the directories. The directories are such a cool thing because they're basically phone books. And with the directories, you know, you can look up your family, you know, look up the last name and everything. And it shows where that person lived, obviously. Their phone number, you know, the cool old phone numbers. And then it also shows if they're married, if they're widowed or anything like that. And it shows their occupation, which is really, really neat. And so here, I'll show you this really quick. Right here, I use my pen. You know, the Fredrickson's right here. And this is actually my, let's see, that's my grandpa. And then, oh no, I'm sorry. That's my Uncle Albert and his wife Loretta. And he worked at CB&Q. This is my great-grandparents, Lewis and Martha. And then, go down a ways. Where'd he go? Because I'm looking through this with my phone. Oh, and by the way, my family, for some odd reason, I don't know why, they played around with the SCN and SON, so that's why this is kind of goofy. But, let's see, where'd he go? I'm sorry. I'm usually more prepared than this. I'm sorry, right here, Lewis. Lewis at the Leland Hotel. So, that's my grandpa, Lewis. Busman over at the Leland Hotel. And that's where he used to live, on 624 High Street. And so it's like, you know, but with these directories, they're fascinating. I mean, see here, you know, like Millard here, you know, he was the operator over at, you know, All Steel and everything. You know, just all sorts of fascinating things that you can find. You know, and this is just a copy I'd gotten from the Aurora Historical Society, actually, which is another really, really cool place to check out. You know, you can always call ahead, make an appointment, and just let them know what you're interested in looking for. So that's one thing. Another thing I use for my research, for my book at least, are like the old Historical Society calendars, actually. So you have like all these, oops, I'm sorry, these oldie photos and everything, which are from the Aurora Historical Society. So, you know, that's the kind of stuff that, you know, I look up. Another thing I look up, I had these books that I actually had gotten from the Aurora celebration that was over at the Aurora Roundhouse. And so I'd gotten these. These were purchased from a booth that was featured by the Aurora Historical Society. So all of these are just really fascinating things. Another thing I have are these, you know, just old ads and everything. You know, you have second balls. I'm sure somebody's going to correct me on that. Just old ads and everything. And these are, the reason why I do these is because I want to be as accurate as possible for the story. And which I hope that people would be able to appreciate once, you know, I finally get it going and everything. But which is a good thing that I did that, because I originally had my two main characters, Ruby and Marie, two best friends, and I had them going to the theater and everything to see, I thought would be a Gary Cooper movie. But because a Gary Cooper movie had came, Sergeant York had came out during that time period of my story, but come to find out, it wasn't even out yet at our theaters. So it's like I had to look up other movie theaters and everything. So I was able to get a different version of a movie for them. Like here, you know, it's I absolutely love these old ads and everything. So it's like, you know, when you go to the library and look up the old ads, the old newspapers, old books and everything, it's just fascinating. And you get to sit there and go back in time, and, you know, and the library's open for, you know, it's open for, you know, quite a few hours and everything. So it's like, you know, things like that, just fascinating. Yeah, so anyways, that's, you know, the gist of what I like to do. I love the history. I love the research and everything. And yes, I do have a photo, old photo, of Leland here. This is from 1940. And that's my photo reference of, you know, for my story. And I have to have that so that, you know, I can, you know, look at that and kind of get an idea of the feel and the look of what I need for my stories, or for my story in my book, and to make sure that I get the right feeling for it. And so, like I said, it's something that I hope everybody will be able to appreciate once it comes out. Like I said, it's been a work in progress, and So it's been a long time, but right now I'm just like going into the tiny nuances of it, you know, to find out, you know, certain businesses and everything, just to make sure I have everything exact, you know, because I don't want somebody to say, oh, that place wasn't on that street. That street didn't even exist then. You know, it wasn't Downer Place, it was Fox Street and everything. So, again, it's just a matter of, you know, making sure I have everything right. But give me a few minutes, and me and Coyote are actually going to take you to the library so you can see what I get to see with the documentation room and everything. So give me one moment and we'll be right there. Here we are. That's Coyote. So we're going to see what I get to look at on for my research and stuff. So here we are at the documentation room at the Aurora Public Library, Santori Library. Here you'll find all sorts of very interesting documents and books. You can look up funeral directories, cemetery directories, birth announcements, death announcements. They even have information on history of some of the older homes in Aurora. According to the Aurora Public Library website, about 80-85% of research on older homes are from the direct result of odd occurrences. And I find that pretty neat if that is the case. And I'm sure, you know, some folks understand why, you know, being on my fascination with things like that. Everything is very well organized, and you can tell that by a lot of the hard work and love was put into creating records of Aurora history. And they not only have just Aurora history, they also have history of the surrounding counties as well. And here you'll see some information about Paul Egan. He was a very interesting mayor of Aurora. He ran for mayor of Aurora in 1953, and for one compelling reason. He just needed a job, and he needed to support a wife and five kids. His term as mayor for surprisingly 8 years was very lively, and which included fist fights with elected officials, and he even appointed a parrot as chief of police. Look him up. You won't regret it. Here you also see the bookshelves that have other documents in Aurora history and surrounding, you know, town history as well. And they also have vintage songbooks, and which are really, really beautiful. And they also have books from local authors. And, you know, when you go in here, you can't really take anything out of this room. Everything has to stay in there. But it's just really nice to just sit in quiet and read and check these things out. Here you see the microfiche drawers that have all the old Beacon newspapers. And from mid-1800s to around present time. And those are really fascinating too, if you want to go back in time and, you know, look up you know, birth announcements or, you know, death announcements in the old papers, and or even history. One thing I found fascinating was that you can find, like, you know, if you go back in the 20s, especially 1929 is my favorite year, because that's the year of the St. Valentine's Day Massacre in Chicago, which I know that's not a good thing to be proud of, but it's fascinating to see it in our local paper. And here you have the microfiche readers, and these are so easy to work with. Because back in the 80s, when I used to play around and check out the old history and everything of Aurora, yes, I was a nerd, but back then at the old library, it was up on the third floor, and you read these and everything, but it was on a very cumbersome machine. Now with today's technology, you can, you know, zoom in on things. I mean, you can zoom in on the old ones too, but, you know, you can, you know, check these things out and zoom in. You can even crop on around a certain article or picture or even an ad. And you can either have the library print it for you, or you can actually email it to yourself, which is even better. And because you can email it to yourself at no cost, and which, you know, everybody loves free. I know I love free. So, but yeah, that's me checking out in some articles from 1941, and which is actually the year my dad was born. So, but this one in particular is July 1941. But yeah, I mean, seriously, you folks should, you know, if you ever have some free time on a Saturday, they're even open on Sunday, and you know, you can just sit in here with some quiet and basically go back in time. All right, so hi, we're here at the Santori Library inside the historical document room, which has all sorts of documents, old newspapers, and everything. Reason why I have you here is to show you what kind of research I like doing. Kind of a little bit of a hobby for me too, but it also comes into play with the book I'm writing. I'm researching 1941 because part of my book is, you know, is featured around 1941. And I'm glad I did do that because I know how some folks are, they're very nitpicky about certain accuracies with Aurora, which I really appreciate because you want things to be as accurate as possible of your hometown. And I don't want to make any mistakes. Granted, there might be some mistakes, but it's going to happen. But I am getting so detailed to down to the point, even like the weather, because when I did my research for June 30th, 1941, which is comes into play with part of my story, the temperature on that day was actually 103 degrees. So I can't like start my story saying, you know, it was a dark and dreary night. It was actually 103 degrees. So, you know, I have to make sure I'm as accurate as possible. But to show you with part of this research, and this is a fascinating thing, you actually get to go back in time. Like here, you have an old ad from Second Buzz, which was an old store in downtown Aurora. Very fascinating store. You know, and this is an ad from June 1st, 1941. And I'm only going into June, you know, to look up ads, look up old movies and everything, because I like to be as accurate as possible. And this is one of the fun things is, yeah, even though you can go onto the group and ask a question, say, hey, you know, does anybody, you know, remember this or that or whatever? That's great, you know, to have, you know, the access to be able to have somebody answer that question for you. But for me, it's even more fun to look, you know, to come to the library, which is a great place. This place is beautiful. I remember the old one was kind of spooky and dark, but it was old. But this place is phenomenal. And even the bathrooms are cool. And but you actually get to go back in time, which for me is so much fun. And being, you know, with writing this book, you have to go back in time in your mind so that you get yourself into that moment and everything. And it helps with, you know, building up your characters. So, you know, I get to look at stuff like this, look up the old newspapers and everything, look up the old directories and all that. So this stuff is fun. So if you ever get a chance, come to the library, come to the third floor and just ask, hey, you know, I'm going to check out the documentation room. Colin, he's been a huge help for me and us, my husband and I, to learn how to put everything together and everything. And, you know, you do need a library card, but what's cool that we found out, being that we live in North Aurora, is that we can get a library card from the library in North Aurora, utilize that to get a library card here. So, you know, that's a good thing to know.
And it won't cost you extra.
And it won't cost you extra.
Right.
Correct, Coyote. And, but also, if you still don't have a library card, they would be more than happy to assist you with signing on and everything, to, you know, go on to the screens. So, with that, I just wanted to share a little bit on, you know, how I enjoy research, our town of Aurora. I love our city. Our city has had a lot of ups and downs and everything, but all in all, it's my hometown and it's your hometown. So, with that, I hope you enjoy this video and hope you come to the library and check out this awesome room. You know, like I say, you get to go back in time and, you know, maybe learn some things about your own family, like I did with, you know, the directories and everything. And you get to look up the old addresses. And you can do a Google search of that address and get to see where where, you know, you're like your great grandparents, great grands and aunts and uncles and everything got to live. So it's a lot of fun. So and that's it. And hope you all have a good day.
You can just imagine the work it took to actually do these newspaper layouts in an era in which you didn't have, you know, a publishing program or something like that, where they actually did typesetting by hand. And this right here, when you look at something like this with all the microfiche and whatnot, it's almost like it's almost like the internet come to life back in the 40s. I mean, wouldn't you say so?
I would say so.
You got a lot of information, I mean, right here at your fingertips, and of course it took a lot of time and a lot of man hours, so to speak, in order to compile and archive this stuff. But, you know, right here as it stands,
and all this and...
Oh yeah, look at this. You've got radio program schedules, stuff like that. Right now, we take that information at our fingertips for granted. We had an Ingrid Bergman movie.
At the Paramount.
Exactly.
And the Tivoli. And?
The Tivoli, where my dad took me to see King Kong back in 76.
The Fox Theater. And the Isle, which was, all these were in downtown Aurora.
Yep.
And you have Arcata, which is in St. Charles.
Yeah. So there was no shortage of entertainment in this city back then, which is, it's really something of a stark contrast to now, where, I mean, there is entertainment, but it's not like something that you would... see en masse. I mean, we still have the Paramount. Tivoli's been gone for many, many, many years.
Which is now the parking lot of the casino.
Right, exactly. I don't even know if the Aurora Hotel is something anymore. I don't even know if that's still around. But, you know, when you think of, like, the internet today, we take that sort of thing for granted because all the information that folks had back then was almost strictly newspapers, periodicals, and radio programs and stuff like that. We were just talking about Superman shorts, you know, that prior to films at the cinema and stuff like that. So, you know, just stuff that we, you know, have, you know, ready, you know, at any given moment today. There was only so much limited news and information distribution.
Yeah, and any news you had to wait until you got the news.
Exactly.
You know, now we have everything at our fingertips.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, now if, you know, you see something online and you get your newspaper the next day, it's already old news.
Exactly.
And here... like Coyote was saying, with this, I mean, that all this took a lot of work, and for all this to be put into a newspaper the very next day, you know, that's a lot of, you know, handiwork and everything. And you know, and that was back when the newspapers were very thick. Now the newspapers are barely anything.
They're hard. Yeah, exactly.
This is a lost talent.
Now, was this, I don't remember, was this an actual daily or was this just a Sunday publication back then? Do you know or do you remember?
These are daily.
Okay, yeah, you're right. This particular one was from Tuesday.
Yeah,
Tuesday. June 3rd.
1941.
Wow, that is a lot of freaking work. I mean, look at that. Like I said, typesetting done by hand, at least I believe so. I'm not, you know, I don't know a whole lot about, you know, print media back then.
Mm-hmm.
I should learn more, you know, being in media myself, but I mean, this is just, you know, like you said, it's a lost art. It's definitely a lost vocation and talent. We don't know what that is anymore. And like you said, those big papers, you know, they're hardly anything. Even the Sundays are hardly anything these days. They're
We had almost, 15 pages of comic strips.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the color and everything.
The sales circulars, I mean, separate sections for everything, whether it was sports or lifestyle or entertainment or whatever.
Right.
You see, she's scrolling through this. You can see
all these.
Sugar Grove graduates get diplomas on June 5. Oswego High School graduates receive diplomas on June 5.
Let's go back a little bit. And it has all these little mini cartoons, too. Chicago child has a royal gift. Little girl from... got a teddy bear from ex-King Carol.
Not sure who that
from,
is.
From the West Indies.
Oh, okay. Wow. Look at that.
So.
Look at that.
Just all fun stuff.
That is cool.
So I hope everybody enjoyed this video. I want to give a huge thank you to the Aurora Public Library, the Santori Library, and Colin, who's always a huge help to us, and Rob Winder for and everybody else who helped out with creating and putting together all the archives and everything of Aurora. It's hugely appreciative, not only for just for research and everything, but for holding close our history of Aurora. One thing I do need to correct, which I'm sure everybody caught, or maybe some people caught, the documentation room is on the second floor. I caught that after the fact. I'm so used to seeing the third floor because it used to be on the third floor. So, sorry about that. And a thank you to Cody, my husband, for putting in his little commentary. Yeah, that's him and my daughter in the background. For putting his commentary in, which I appreciate so much, because he didn't have to, but he sat in there with me, helping me with this video. He could have been in one of the other areas, reading a book or reading comic books, which is one of his pleasures. But he sat there and watched, and I love the fact that he was intrigued with the sofa I was looking at. And used it to his own advantage, you know, being in the media and everything. So that's something I really appreciate. And I hope that there are people, you know, you folks, who would appreciate and would utilize. If there's something you want to look up or look into, contact the library, contact the Aurora Historical Society. They're all great people. And they love it when you want help, because this is their passion too. I have such a passion for history and everything, which that's something I wish I would have, you know, been able to get myself more into in life, but, you know, just, that's just how life goes. But, you can always, you know, do something now. It's just fantastic stuff. And being that, being that we live in North Aurora, we're told by Colin that if we have a library card from the Messenger Library of North Aurora, that we can get a library card at no charge from the Aurora Library. So, thank you, Colin. We went and got our grants backwards. We got our Messenger Libraries, both Coyote and I, and which I thought was kind of cool that he wanted one too. So, I love, you know, how this had created a passion for him as well. Just from sitting there watching me, you know, do this and everything. And, I just have such a love for history, especially a love for the history of our city. We're the second largest city in Illinois. And there's so much history behind Aurora. Not just, you know, with, you know, Leland and everything, but, when you look back on these old, newspapers, which I actually, for fun, I went back onto 1929. And which was the year of the St. Valentine's Day massacre, and so I downloaded some. Oh, that's the other thing too. The other cool part about the microfiche is that, because back in the day when I used to play around with it when I was in high school, you had to pay. I think it was like 25 cents for a copy or whatever you wanted. And but now, being that with technology and everything, doing everything on the computer, you can click on whatever you want. You can crop, you know, like an article or an ad or story or whatever you want, and email it to yourself at no charge, which is even better. So now with all this research I do and everything, I can send myself as much stuff as I need, send it home, and just print it out at home. So that's the other plus about the Aurora Public Library, Santori Library. So I hope you folks enjoy this journey with me. Like I said, I just wanted to share my bit of a passion for history of our town. Like I said, Aurora is my hometown. Aurora is everybody's hometown. This is our town that we've created. The town was founded on industry and entertainment. To see, like in these old ads, how much entertainment there was back in the day. I mean, I think we had like five or six movie houses. And correct me if I'm wrong. I'm sure a lot of people are going to be like, oh, no, we had more, we had less, or whatever, which I totally understand. I mean, there were, like, dance houses and everything. I mean, downtown Aurora was the place to be back in the day. And we need that again, which I know it's getting back to that, which is great. You know, I just hope that everybody has that passion of Aurora. Not just downtown Aurora, not just, you know, the Aurora-Naperville borderline of Aurora, Aurora in itself. You know, Aurora's our town, and we make it what we want it to be. And Aurora's my town, your town, everybody's town. I know I'm going on and on, but you know what? I love Aurora. That's why. And because I have my family history here, and I don't know, it's just fantastic. And I love the fact that I can utilize the history of Aurora for my book. And if you're ever interested on my other tactics that I utilize for my book, leave a comment, message me, whatever you want to do. You know, I'd be happy to talk about it. The story's still a work in progress. It's been 8 years that I've been working on this, believe it or not. And I'm now getting some big-time groundwork with it, only because I'm finally able to find some time to do it. But yeah, just little things that I've found and grabbed up. Yeah, I have my copies of old ads here. I have all sorts of fun things that, you know, I've utilized. Another thing here, if you can see, old books I've gotten from the, these are available at the David Pierce Center, but I got these from when we had the Aurora celebration at the Roundhouse a few years ago, which was so much fun too, because you got to see like all the, you know, things. But I wish you guys lots of love, peace to you, and good day and good night. Love y'all. Ta-ta.